dear friend. This will greatly improve our operations.
And a new cook to replace me. I've heard of the man. Surprisingly decent. Which means we can't have him making magic dust for the bad guy. So we are going to divert the helicopter on which he is arriving.
Control tower to flight WWH34. We're closed for a moment. We've got a bunch of looks like gators. They're all in the tarmac. Yeah, we're sending a cleanup crew, but please divert to the coordinates we've uploaded. Okay, thanks. Over. About you. Your product is fantastic. Wait to have you working in our lab. Let's get going. Himself Fiddlestick.
I also happen to know Fiddlestick's supplier, and his supplier likes me better. So he told me where their shipments are coming through. I shall text you the GPS coordinates, and then you can, you know, do what you do best.
Shut down, so do a lot of our operations. This has to be a Jackson Duke move. He and the judge go way back. And the thing is, Tarpon's corrupt and we got evidence and leaked it to the feds. They kicked off an investigation. He should be going down right now, but, well, we're gonna need someone's help. Her name's Marie, and, you'll see. A couple of quick rules. One, let me do the talking. Two, try not to look her right in the eye. And three, well...
What the hell are you doing here, Alain? I don't remember summoning you.
The witnesses in the case against Judge Tarpon are starting to either clam up or disappear entirely. We need to get into the witness protection business, or Tarpon's gonna continue to be a pain in our collective asses. Only thing is, we don't know who the witnesses are. Maybe you could, like, invoke the spirits or something and find out?
Yes, leave now and I will do so. I will send you their names and locations.
And my boy here will find them and keep them alive. Great. Solid. Sounds like a... Okay. You got this, right?
Shit, that boy. solidifies this afternoon, so Judge Tarpon won't be barking up our tree anymore. Len out.
There seems to be a new spiritual presence in the vicinity, weakening my abilities. Placed a curse on a degenerate gambler to whom I had loaned a significant sum of money, as is my business. And he has now fallen behind on his payments towards said loan. I declare that if he did not repay what he borrowed by midnight last night, that he would drown inside his own limousine. That night has come and gone, and the man still lives. I don't know why. You are Alain's partner, and I have a partnership with Alain, which means we are a team. And we cannot have our enemies and those indebted to us believing we will root out the cause. But first, we need to deal with this. The gambler's car must end up at the bottom of the valley. Find it and pick him up, posing as the driver. I'm sure you can figure out the rest.
You're picking me up in a good mood. I'm up 900, baby. Luck with the lady today. I know, you're going to lecture me about how I'm not really up considering past losses, but perspective's not very high on my priority list. Right now, Hector, we're going to celebrate. The usual cheap sets and expensive drinks. You know the place. Let's go then. You sure this is the right way? Thank you.
Reaper has come to pass. Let that be a lesson to those who would doubt. Once again, my powers are faltering. Most distressing. I must discover the cause, but a more pressing matter vies for my attention. One of my former strongmen has proven to be as loyal as he is intelligent.